Social Welfare Secretary Rolando Bautista visited several areas today that were hit by Tuesday's quake in Mindanao. The DSWD Secretary now joins us on the line. Mr. Secretary, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron.
Hi, sir. Now, you were able to interact with the people affected by the quake. How are they doing?
Yeah, good. Actually, I was able to visit four evacuation centers, and I was able to see the situation. And apparently, since the DSWD had a quick reaction team, so they immediately provided the immediate assistance to the victims of the earthquake.
Mm-hmm. How many areas did you visit, Mr. Secretary?
After I visited evacuation sites, these areas were the heavily hit by the earthquake. Meaning to say that the intensity ranges from 6.6 to 7 magnitude.
And would you have the number of families who are in evacuation centers right now, sir?
Actually, the first evacuation site that I visited is in Daig, Tulunan, municipality of Tulunan, and there are actually 344 families in that evacuation site. Then we also have a site assessment. We are supposed to go to one of the evacuation sites in Tulunan, that is in Bakong, Barangay Bakong. Apparently, the road was cut off due to landslide, but we were able to talk to one of the barangay officials there, and he mentioned that there are 500 families who are staying in the evacuation sites. But we were not able to proceed to the evacuation site, as I mentioned, because of the landslide, and there's still tremor that is occurring during that time.
Right.
Then I also visited the evacuation site in Barangay Lumabis, Kilapawan, wherein there are 1,113 families on the site. And the last one was one of the barangays in Saysay, Davao del Sur, wherein there are 500 families at the evacuation site.
That's at least 2,500 families if you're just talking about those four evacuation sites. And we did hear that some other families are staying in temporary shelters, not in those evacuation centers. What do you think, sir, is their most immediate need right now?
You're correct. There still will be coming in these evacuation sites. Actually, I did not. What I only mentioned are those evacuation sites where the earthquake is really in huge intensity.
Right.
But there are also some evacuation sites which is outside of this evacuation site that I've mentioned.
Mm-hmm.
And as I have talked to the locals in these four evacuation sites, and even the local chief executives, they're expecting that more will be coming because some are just fixing their things, and some are being forced to vacate their current shelters because until now there are still aftershocks that appears and being felt. In fact, when we were in the barangays, there was an aftershock, and when we were in Barangay Magsaysay, we also felt a tremor during that time. And
right.
You mentioned the assistance, immediate assistance needed there. On our side, on the DSWD, apparently we have requisitioned food packs. In fact, we have already provided every family one food pack each, which will last for 2 days, then after which we will provide another food pack. Then we also provided cash assistance for those who are wounded or those who who have some pains that they got during the earthquake. We also provided them non-food items like the laminated sacks intended for temporary shelters. In fact, they really need that material because it is raining on that evacuation site. We also provided them tents because I observed that there are lots of families who are who do not have a shelter because some of the shelters that have been erected were already full.
Right.
And other than that, we also provided burial assistance for those who were died because of some were hit by the buildings.
Mm-hmm. The debris.
Then emergency shelter. We also give them a cash amount for those houses who were damaged. This will be given after the assessment of the SWD, DPWH, and the LGU on the extent of damage of their houses.
Right.
For the partially damaged, we give them 15,000. For the totally damaged, we give them 30,000. And we also give them cash forward, meaning to say that they can do works in cleaning the road, cleaning the school buildings, among others. So those are the assistance provided by the DSWD.
Okay.
On the other agencies, I think one of the very one thing right now there is the medicine for the families, particularly the children, especially now that there's a continuous rain on the evacuation site.
Oh.